Hi, and welcome to this primary maths lesson where we are going to have a look at equivalent fractions. So don't panic if you've not heard that phrase before. And if you are really, really, really unfamiliar with fractions and have no idea what one is, then go back to the previous videos in this series where we look at an introduction to fractions. But today, equivalent fractions, what do I mean by the phrase equivalent fractions? Well, it means fractions that are exactly the same. So we're going to have a look at fractions that are identical and how we can simplify them. So let's crack on. Equivalent fractions. Now we're going to start with a nice simple one. We are going to have a look at a half, okay, one half. Now I would write a half, and hopefully we're all nice and familiar with this. I would write a half as 1/2. If I imagine that I've got a square, hopefully with less wibbly wobbly lines, and I cut my square into four pieces and I want half of the pieces, okay, I'm going to shade in half of the pieces. I've shaded in 2 out of 4. That's the same as a half. In the same way, if I had one that was 6 squares and I wanted half of it, I would shade in 3 out of 6 squares, which means a half is also the same as 3/6. If I had one that was even bigger, let's go for a much bigger one, and I'm going to divide it into so wibbly wobbly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 14. I want to shade in half of this. I'm going to shade the top row, aren't I? Because that would be half of it. Which means I've shaded a half is the same as 7 out of 14. These are all equivalent fractions. They're all the same as a half. Let's have a look at how we can do this without having to draw it out each time. So if I start with a half, I can times the top and the bottom of the fraction by the same number. Let's double them. If I double 1, I get 2. And if I double 2, I get 4. If I double them again, I can double 2 to get 4, and I can double 4 to get 8. That's also an equivalent fraction. So I can make equivalent fractions by timesing the top and bottom of my fraction by the same number. So I could take a half and I could times the top and the bottom by 5. And that would get me an equivalent fraction of 5/10. As long as I do the same to the top and the bottom, I will make an equivalent fraction. Ah, there we go. So if I have a half and I want to make a 20th, well, I've times the 2 by what? What have I times the 2 by? By 10. So I can times the 1 by 10 as well. Remember, I have to times it by the same to give me 10/20. And that's my equivalent fraction. Let's have a look at some of these not including a half. So let's go for something trickier. Let's go for a third. Same thing. I can double the top and the bottom as long as I do the same. So 1 times 2 is 2. 3 times 2 is 6. I could times the top and bottom by 3. So 1 times 3 is 3. 3 times 3 is 9. Excellent. What about if I wanted to make them times by 12? Well, as long as I do the same to the top and the bottom, I'm going to get an equivalent fraction. So that means a third is the same as 12/36. And these are all equivalent fractions. So now it's time for you to have a go. I'm going to leave that up for you to use. But could you turn a quarter into eighths? What have I times the bottom by? I've times it by, if you said two, excellent stuff. So I have to times the top by two to give me 2/8. Brilliant, well done. What about if I want to turn a fifth into 20ths? Have a go for me. Well, I've times the bottom by four, so I times the top by four to get me 4/20. Excellent, well done. Okay, one even trickier one. This time, I'm gonna turn 3/8 into 24ths. I could times the bottom by three. I've times 8 by 3 to get to 24. So I'm going to times the top by 3 to get me 9/24. And that's how we make equivalent fractions. Now we can use equivalent fractions to simplify our answers when we do a sum. So when we do all that good stuff we've done before of our adding and our subtracting and our timesing and our dividing, we might get a fraction that can be simplified. And that means we can divide the top and bottom by a number until it can't be divided anymore. Okay, so let's have a look at 20/40. Okay, this might be an answer to my sum and I want to simplify it until it's in its simplest form. Okay, well, what goes into both 20 and 40? Well, I know they're both even, so I could divide by 2, but they also both end in a 0, which means they're both in the 10 times table. So I'm going to divide the top and bottoms by 10. And again, I have to do the same to the top as the bottom. So 20 divided by 10 gives me 2, and 40 divided by 10 gives me 4. So I have now got 2/4. But I can still simplify that because I can divide them both by 2 to give me 1/2. I've now simplified my fraction into its simplest form. I can't divide any further because the only number that goes into 1 and 2 is 1, and we don't simplify using 1. Okay? Let's have a go at another one. This time I'm going to have 15/20. I now need to think of a number that goes into both 15 and 20. 5. 5 goes into both 15 and 20. So I'm going to divide them both by 5. 15 divided by 5 gives me 3. 20 divided by 5 gives me 4. And so my simplified fraction is 3/4. Let's do one more to make sure we've definitely got that. You have a go first and then I will tell you the answer. So let's simplify 18/30. That's a tough one. Have a go. What number goes into both 18 and 30? Well, there are a few, actually. We could halve them both. Actually, let's do that. Let's halve them both. So I'm going to divide both of them by 2. 18 divided by 2, half of 18 is 9. Half of 30 is 15. What goes into both 9 and 15? Is there a number that goes into both of them? Yes, 3. So I could simplify it further. So I'm going to divide them both by 3. 9 divided by 3 is going to give me 3. 15 divided by 3 is going to give me 5. And that simplified would have been 3/5. If I wanted to do that in one step, I could have divided by 6 to get the fraction in one step. And there we have it. That is equivalent fractions. And we can use equivalent fractions to simplify our answers to our fraction sums. Now, there is a worksheet that accompanies this lesson. Please go and have a practice. Maths is all about the practice. It's not very long, I promise. If you have any questions, please pop them in the box below. But otherwise, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next session where we're going to look at improper fractions and mixed number fractions. So have a great rest of your day, guys, and I'll see you then. Take care. Bye.